I've been searching like everybody else. Can't say nothing different about myself. Sometimes I'm an angel and sometimes I'm cruel. And when it comes to love, I'm just another fool. Yes, I'll climb a mountain. I'm gonna swim the sea. There ain't no act of God, girl, could keep you safe from me. My arms are reaching out, out across this canyon. I'm asking you to be my true companion, true companion, true companion. So don't you dare and try to walk away. I've got my heart set on our wedding day. I've got this vision of a girl in white. Made my decision that it's you, alright. When I take your hand, I'll watch my heart set sail. I'll take my trembling finger and I'll lift up your veil. Then I'll take you home. And with wild abandon, make love to you just like a true companion. You are my true companion. I got a true companion. Oh, a true companion. When the years have done irreparable harm, I can see us walking slowly arm in arm, just like that couple on the corner do. 'Cause girl, I will always be in love with you. When I look in your eyes, I still see that spot. Until the shadows fall, until the room grows dark, then when I leave this earth, I'll be with the angels standing. I'll be out there waiting for my true companion, just for my true companion, true companion, true companion.
I do.
Thank you, Mr. Man. It's an honor. Try. Come on up.
You may be seated. We'll keep trying. Hello, check. Okay, good. I'll talk loud. Welcome. On behalf of the Vanyans, the McKenzies, you have come to see a wedding, and you will. But more, this is actually a celebration for you two. A celebration where we're all celebrating who you are and what God has brought together. Such an honor to be here with you two. I want you just to take a look back behind you really quick. Just take a little look at these people. Just wave, check them out. We are here on your behalf. No kissing yet.
I wasn't. Okay. Just okay. Sweet nothings.
They're trying to kiss and it's getting awkward up here, so you can't see that.
Just wait for the booty grab.
It's good. But we're actually all here on your behalf because we love you guys and are thankful for you and want to support you guys. So we've known each other most of our lives, Tracy, your whole family. It's such an honor to be here doing this with you guys. And we've known each other for many years and now we're just kind of rekindling. And you're a total stud. So I'm so thankful for Tracy to marry such a great, great guy. So I told you that the other day, but I'm really sincere with that.
Thank you.
Last night was quite an experience, and you will get an experience like this, I'm hoping, today, Grandma May. So Grandma May will do some poetry, and let's just say, I should just have her do the rest of this ceremony. I think it would be pretty great. Let's pray. Thank you, Lord, that you are here. You are not distant, but you are here among us. Thank you that you brought these two together in your timing, as frustrating as I'm sure that has been. Thank you for how you brought them together. We all just are grateful for what you've done and how you've orchestrated this relationship. Thank you that it's actually built upon you. Thank you that you are their hope. Thanks for life today. In your name, Jesus, we get to pray this. Amen. In the beginning, God created man. And God gave us the earth. God created the heavens and the earth. God gave us all the pets. God even gave us Visalia. You know, and I don't know if he created that necessarily, but we'll see. But God gave us all the pets, like Bertuzzi.
Yes.
And Millie. And Hope.
Amen.
Yep, amen. Amen. Up here, this is good. And God saw right away that this was incomplete, that man was incomplete without a helper, without a supporter. So he made woman. God made woman. Men?
Amen.
He said again, God made woman. Okay. Beautiful. And God made you together, and God made you to complement one another, which you guys do in so many ways. Just so great. It's fun to hear your story and hear how God has literally put you two together to develop you and strengthen both of you in areas that you're weak. It's just going to be awesome. I'm excited about that. Because God is the author and the creator of love and of marriage, I thought it would be appropriate to kind of read some things that he says about this. In Mark, at the beginning of creation, God made them male and female. For this reason, a man will leave his father and mother and will be united to his wife, and the two will become one flesh. So they are no longer two, but actually one. Therefore, what God has joined together, let no man separate. Corinthians. The husband should fulfill his marital duty to his wife, and likewise the wife to her husband. The wife's body does not belong to her alone, but also to her husband. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
In the same way, the husband's body does not belong to him alone, but also to his wife.
Amen.
Amen. Galatians. But the Holy Spirit produces this kind of fruit in our lives. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. I'm going to read those again. I was thinking about this today. What a gift that as you guys have already started your relationship on the foundation of Jesus, that these are actually the gifts that he gives us, the fruit that comes out of you guys walking with Jesus together. I'll read these again. This is the fruit of walking in step with the Holy Spirit. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. I asked both of you guys to send me things that you love about the other, so I just wanted to share those in front of all these good people. And Jamie, this is what Tracy loves about you. She loves how passionate you are. She loves how smart you are, how fun and funny you are. Two different words, but very distinct. She loves how hardworking you are. You're a spiritual leader. She loves to pray with you. I'm thankful that you want to pray with her and lead her in that. She loves that you're quick to forgive, that you're honest. You're a big dreamer. She loves your family, which is a great thing. And she loves that you love God, which is beautiful. And Tracy, Jamie wrote this, and I quote, "I love Tracy's faith and that she can trust in the Lord and his plan in every step of her life. Also, her unconditional love for me radiates in everything she says and does. Amazingly, that unconditional love makes me want to be a better person for her rather than want to test if it really is unconditional. That same love also allows me to be more aware of Christ's unconditional love for me and allows me to draw closer to him. Tracy has so many qualities that I adore about her, but she has two specific qualities that I've never really seen completed in another person. Tracy is not only the sweetest person I've ever met, she is also the strongest person I've ever met. And those qualities coupled together in her not only inspire me, they make me fall in love harder with her every time I'm with her, everything she says and interactions. These are great reasons for marriage. I think the things that even we talked about the other day are these are the things that brought you to each other, and these will be some of the things that will drive you crazy about the other person in both ways. But to honestly remember these things, to even give those things that you wrote to me to one another and hold them up and say, okay, I love you because of these reasons. You are great. Your friendship is so important. I loved how they started their relationship just by email, via email. And it's a pretty classic story. I love it. They were set up by Susan Bramall. Praise God, wherever she is.
Big ups.
Big ups.
To Susan.
And they were just sending emails back and forth every day. Daily, they just send emails back and forth. And Jamie was saying, and they were both saying, that they were already falling in love with each other. And they hadn't even met, hadn't even talked. I didn't even see each other's pictures, so he was like, I hope she's good looking. Because he was like, I'm already kind of undone with this. So, thankfully, she was beautiful, and he was super excited, a little bit.
Stoked.
And Tracy had the same experience. Obviously, you know, semi-good looking guy. But a great man, you were already falling in love with this guy, and they said they just wanted to be slow enough so the families wouldn't be freak out because it was too quick. I thought it was great, but you were already in love and excited to be with one another. Then you met and you were okay. Anyways, love your story. The biggest thing is connecting with your creator. As I already said, he's the author, and author of love, author of marriage, author of grace, author of forgiveness, author of intimacy, author of joy, individually and as a couple. So Eric is going to get up and read a little bit out of God's word.
Therefore, as God's chosen people, holy and dearly loved, clothe yourself with compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience. Bear with each other and forgive whatever grievances you may have against one another. Forgive as the Lord forgave you, and over all these virtues put on love, which binds them all together in perfect unity. Let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, since as members of one body you were called to peace. And be thankful. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly as you teach and admonish one another with all wisdom, as you sing psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs with gratitude in your hearts to God. And whatever you do, whether in word or deed, do it all in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him. Wives, submit to your husbands as is fitting in the Lord. Husbands, love your wives and do not be harsh with them. Got it?
That wasn't supposed to happen. Okay, I'm going to have you face one another so I can... Jamie, do you take Tracy to be your lawfully wedded wife?
I do.
Tracy, do you take Jamie to be your lawfully wedded husband?
I do.
We're going to go through some vows here, and I'm going to have you repeat after me, Tracy. And let me just read them first so you know what you're actually agreeing to.
Okay.
I commit myself to you for the rest of my life to love and cherish you, to honor and protect you, to forgive and serve you, and to receive you as my gift from God. So repeat after me. I commit myself to you for the rest of my life.
I commit myself to you for the rest of my life.
To love and cherish you.
To love and cherish you.
To honor and protect you.
To honor and protect you.
To forgive and serve you.
To forgive and serve you.
And to receive you as my gift from God.
And to receive you as my gift from God.
Jamie, repeat after me.
All right.
I commit myself to you for the rest of my life.
I commit myself to you for the rest of my life.
To love and cherish you.
To love and cherish you.
To honor and protect you.
To honor and protect you.
To forgive and serve you.
To forgive and serve you.
And to receive you as my gift from God.
And to receive you as my gift from God.
These rings, or it's a cliche that they are a symbol of unending love because they're round, right? But it's true. It's true. It's these things we remember as we are walking through our days. We remember God's love for us. It takes actually these weddings sometimes to remind us of that, doesn't it, old married people? You know, you kind of go, oh, well, yeah, it does. It should remind me of God's never-ending love for me. And then that's our love for our spouse. So would you take the ring, put it on her finger, and repeat after me. Tracy, this ring I give you.
Tracy, this ring I give you.
Is a symbol of our trust.
It's a symbol of our trust.
And never-ending love.
And never-ending love.
Tracy, repeat it. Jamie, this ring I give you.
Jamie, this ring I give you.
Is a symbol of our trust.
It's a symbol of our trust.
And never-ending love.
And never-ending love.
Can I kiss her yet?
Not yet.
Big truth.
Let love be without hypocrisy. Abhor what is evil, cling to what is good. Be devoted to one another in brotherly love. Give preference to one another in honor, not lagging behind in diligence, fervent in spirit, serving the Lord, rejoicing in hope, persevering in tribulation. Devoted to prayer, contributing to the needs of the saints, practicing hospitality.
Well, you guys have chosen to take communion, so that's what we're going to do right now. While they were eating, Jesus took bread, he gave thanks and broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body." Then he took the cup and gave thanks and offered it to them, saying, "Drink from it, all of you. This is my blood of the covenant, which is poured out for many for the forgiveness of sins. The bread represents Jesus' body given for us. This is how we remember God in the flesh. Actually, this is the perfect reminder of Christmas, that God is near. Emmanuel, God is actually with us. So when we take that, that's what we remember, that he is with you in marriage. He is with you in the good times and the bad times, which you guys know very well. The cup. This cup represents the brand new promise or covenant that Jesus made on that night that he died for us. We would have forgiveness of sins and eternal life with him. So I'm going to take communion together. This is the body of Christ given for you. Body of Christ given for you. This is the blood of Christ given for you. You can just, yeah, take the bread. Doesn't matter the order. Take a big swig if you need it. I'm praying with you guys. Thank you for dying. Thank you for showing us, modeling grace, forgiveness. Would you remind them just how much you are in love with them, even as they take this? Remember that you are here and that you promised to walk with them through this time. In your name, Jesus. Amen. Let's go back. Because God designed the family and God designed marriage, he can make it work best. It sounds cliche, but it's actually true. Thus, God sent Jesus for us to have a more tangible understanding of how to walk and talk, forgive, how to love, how to serve, and be compassionate. We talked about this the other day, that Jesus wants us to be his representers, right? Representing him to everybody that we meet. So you get to do that now together as one, which is beautiful, in his power and his strength. So because of your commitments to one another, your vows, the exchange of rings, it's my responsibility and privilege to pronounce you husband and wife. You might finally kiss your bride. Yeah. It's getting awkward up here. Why don't you guys turn around?
I got a little.
Okay. It is my special pleasure to be the first to introduce to you Mr. and Mrs. Jamie and Tracy McKinney.
Can call my own.
I found a thrill to press my cheek to, a thrill that I have never known. Oh yeah, you smile, oh, and then the spell was cast, and here we are in heaven. For you are mine at
next name. His name is James. Let's give James a round of applause. Can you do a good job today? And what's your girls' names? Mary and?
Aubrey.
Aubrey, give them a round of applause too. I'm John, I'm your DJ and MC today. I'm also Jamie's college roommate. So that's the whole thing, so we're good. Where's our parents? Yes, Viola. Viola Grad's the name. Parents and grandparents, let's give them a big round of applause. Congratulations to you guys. All right, ladies and gentlemen, if you would focus on that back door over there. Kristen and Eric, come on in. Let's give them a round of applause. Next we have Rebecca and Ray. Give them a round of applause. They come on in. Jamie's sister Jordan and Chris. Give them a round of applause. We have Tracy's sister Lisa and Trevor. Jamie's cousin from Nova Scotia. Lisa's also our matron of honor this evening. Next we have our maid of honor and sister Heather and best man Mark. Come on out. Guys. Ladies and gentlemen, this time I'm going to ask you to all stand up. Because I'm going to introduce you for the very second time this evening, Mr. and Mrs. Jamie McKenzie. This time, Jamie and Tracy are going to go right into their first dance. Can you all say aww?
Aww.
Now.
Thank you, Chris. At this time, you guys can be seated. Bridal party, please find your seats also.
Have you all here. I think we've covered Canada and the United States from west to east, and we just appreciate people coming and partaking the celebration of Jamie and Tracy. Actually, it's fitting that this is Valentine's weekend, and you're the stars, guys, and we're just excited for you. As a father, I can tell that Tracy is a very, very good choice. Because Jamie's happier, he's better to get along with at home. And you know what? We won't get as many calls from Visalia, I'm sure, than we do now, because he's got someone that'll be taking care of him. So anyway, thank you so much for coming, and we're just looking forward to the celebration this evening. Thank you.
Now we're going to hear from Nova Scotia. Trevor, if you would say prayers for us before we eat. Thank you.
Okay, so we'll see if we can pray properly and represent the East Coast. All right, let's just give thanks. Father, this is just a beautiful day. It's an amazing celebration. And so we ask that your presence be with us, that you bless this food, that your blessing be over Jamie and Tracy, and just be among us today. And we just bless this day in Jesus' name. Amen.
First off, it's an honor to be here with celebrate this day with Tracy and Jamie over the other day. And it's funny that Tim mentioned that God created Visalia in his in the ceremony, because when I first met Jamie was when he moved up to Visalia, and I had the task of helping him find a house to rent when he was first moving there. First thing I said to him was, "Are you sure you want to move here? Coming from where you're coming from, you know, the population of cows exceeds the population of people where you're moving." So I wasn't sure that he was ready for that culture shock, is what I call it. But I was a good tour guide, no matter what he says, he'll disagree. But thinking about Tracy, and I was like, she's great, and I hope he doesn't mess this up, because I don't know really why she wants to be with him. But no, he's a good guy. And I'm just honored to be here, and congratulations, and remember, it's just the beginning, the best is still ahead, so congratulations.
I'm Tracy's oldest sister, and that means basically for most of our growing up years, I told her what to do and bossed her around. I have mellowed with age, and I found that a lot, instead of telling her what to do, I end up wishing for things for her instead. And one of the things that, when thinking about the wedding, that I was wishing for her was that my mom would be here. So excuse me if I'm terrible about this. But one of the things that I didn't even hear or see that a friend of mine had told me was that they saw my mom saw one of her friends down the hall, and she went out just, you know, smiling from ear to ear, waving her hands and going, "My baby's getting married today!" And I just love that story, because not only is it so her, but it also just showed me how much, you know, she loved me, and also how much she loved my husband. And, you know, the thing that I just thought about was that even though she's not here, now we can't see her here, you know, I have no doubt she's in heaven smiling and saying, "My baby's getting married today to a friend there." And so I just wish for you a very happy marriage, long life together, and just ridiculous amounts of fun and happiness. And with just God's Jesus in every marriage, I'm blessed to you. Girl.
Hi everyone, I'm Trevor Hammond, I'm Jamie's cousin from the East Coast of Canada, Halifax, Nova Scotia. So Jamie and Tracy, I just want to say congratulations. It's an amazing day for you, and you see how God has worked in these guys, and he's brought them together, and so it's such a beautiful story. I've known Jamie his whole life. I remember the birth announcement from Mackenzie Enterprises, which was one of the most creative birth announcements. It said they celebrate their latest project, which is Jamison Wallace. And so we really grew up together in many ways, and there's a lot of stories around it. One of the things, Jamie is, I don't know how many of you know, but he's a master of the comeback. So at one point, we used to vacation together in Parksville, which is on the west coast of Vancouver Island. And Jamie and myself, my sister and Jordan, we were all playing together, and there was a playground bully. And she's going around the playground, she's calling everyone names, and she's being generally nasty, and us older kids are shouting things back. Jamie's about 5 years old at the time. So she's going, "You're stupid, you're dumb," and you know, we're trying to fight. And Jamie looks around and he just kind of pipes up in this moment of silence and says, "Well, you're a piece of sparkling sand." Thing about that was this little girl burst into tears and went running away to tell her dad. So, if the situation ever gets intense, you know you can call on the piece of sparkling sand to truly come to that. We did vacations in Cultus Lake, and I think Jamie and I one summer spent probably $100 on this video game called Karate Jam. Where they would go toe-to-toe. Then, when we were playing Karate Jam, the only other thing to do was we would sneak into this, right to the shore of this Bible camp and disturb all the campers. So we would go right to the edge of the shore and we'd yell, "Wake up, campers!" at the top of our lungs. We did this probably every day. And then I think eventually they caught on to our scheme. So one day we were standing right at the river's edge and we yelled, "Wake up, campers!" These two, like, 20-year-old guys come burning out of the bushes, chasing us. We ran as fast as we could and got away. We thought, like, our plans get ruined. What are we going to do now? So Jamie and I got the bright idea one night after the sunset. We went off the dock and we swam into the camp. Frogman style. We went right up to the shore to help wake up campers. Under the water, disappear. We see all the lights go on, but there was no sign of us. So anyway, the fun continued. But we want to celebrate with you guys. There's a lot of good memories, and there's a lot of good memories that you'll create, and your family will create as time goes on. And so, one of the encouragements that I was thinking for you is, there's this great story in the Bible in the Old Testament in Exodus, and Moses says, he's talking to God, and he says, "Don't even send us anywhere unless your presence goes with us." And so that's what I want to bless you guys with, that your life and your home and your family would be filled with the presence of God. So let's give a toast to Tracy and Jamie.
Hello! Oh my goodness. I think I'm just going to sit here for a moment having Tracy get a little nervous about what I'm going to say. Too. So one of the first funny things when Tracy first started dating Jamie, the emails went back and forth, and Tracy would just be in the garage reading the emails, emailing for hours, and I'm like, what on earth? Like, I could tell something was serious quickly, which was putting my red alert flag up for a lot of different reasons. So my red alert flag's up, and it's about 2 weeks into them meeting each other, and I walk down the hallway, and I see this paper bag, and I see the game Password, and then Taboo. and probably Cranium. I don't know. There's a whole bag of board games. And I said, this is serious. This is so serious. Tracy's already bringing out the board games after 2 weeks. And Jamie, that is because Tracy, for our life, would always buy us games for Christmas. So we turned 20 and we're thinking now we're going to get earrings or something normal. But it was games. So when I saw the games, I was like, he's a keeper. He's going to be so serious. So, you know, I've been reflecting back just today. It's kind of like a slideshow in my brain of seasons. And I think we're hitting, in the Vanden family, a new season. And not to reflect on all the difficult seasons, but it's just so fun to be a witness to this beautiful union, really, which it is. And Jamie, I love you. It's so beautiful to see this and to see how God has woven you guys together and taken a lot of heartache and made something strong. So it's just a blessing to be a part of it and to kind of be able to spend time with you. So I look forward to lots of good family time here and then good family time with Lisa and Andy. And I just feel like our family is coming together in a beautiful time. Thank you. This goes to Tracy and Jamie and their beautiful maybe family to be and just lots of years.
Message on our college room message machine, and she rapped for us. So I know you're in for a treat right now, so if you all would give her your undivided attention at this time, that would be great. Thank you very much.
So I can see. All the kids got a poem except Jordan, and at that time Papa was sick, so I didn't get a poem for her. So if I mention her in this too, it'll be okay, because her and Jamie have always been good friends. I woke up one night, my mind in a frenzy. I must write a poem for Jamie McKenzie. He's my grandson, and I love him well. So everything I know, I mustn't tell. Let's start at the beginning with Gordy and Jen. They loved little Jordan, but asked the stork when he'd be coming back with a nice wee boy that would bring to them some extra joy. The stork brought Jamie, saying, "Nothing you lack. I'm flying away now and I'm not coming back." Jamie was so cute. I'm prejudiced, I know. But I saw him a lot, as to babysit I'd go. I never spanked Jamie, he was a good little kid. Jordan, well, I'll admit now that I did. I did. One night, Jen put Jordan and Jamie to bed. "Now, don't talk to each other," she sternly said. Minutes later, Jen goes upstairs to see. Jamie was calling, "Mommy, Jordan, talk to me." One time in lovely Palm Springs, as a Vancouverite, there my heart sings. Jordan said, "It's so warm, I think I'll drop. Could we have money to buy some pop?" "Okay," said Jen, "but hear what I say. No Coke, only tap. on this warm, sunny day. So back the kids come with ice-cold cans, and guess what Jordan had in her hands? She looked real guilty, as quiet as a mouse, said Gord. What did Mommy say when you left the house? In a quiet voice, little Jordan spoke. She said I wasn't to buy a Coke. Did you obey what your mommy said? No, I didn't. And she hung her wee head. So Daddy took away the offending drink and poured all that Coke right down the sink. Meanwhile, Jamie, enjoying his drink so fab, said, Jordan, you want some of my tab? Jamie watched, and I thought, listened real well, as Gordy knelt down, little Jordan, to tell. Disobedience at any time is really quite bad. He forgave her, kissed her, and said, don't be sad. Meanwhile, Jamie, on the bar stool so tall, did this fatherly lesson affect him at all? Because Jamie grew up and had his moments, a few. I won't tell all, he wouldn't like me to, but early and eagerly, he learned to drive. He caught on quickly, and then it seemed to thrive. Speed was his passion, as into his truck he hopped, and then very soon by the police he was stopped. Young man, you know, and I know, that you were speeding, so an expensive ticket you'll now be needing. Now Jamie, though he didn't seem like a dunce, wouldn't you think he'd do that just once? I thought, this kid must be in a coma, as he kept getting in trouble with his new Sonoma. I know he collected tickets galore, but that never stopped him from getting some lots more. So Gordy and Jen had to teach their lad, and that lovely truck he no longer had. Back to the dealer the new Sonoma went, and Jamie, ashamed, was surely not content to ride a bike in classy Newport Beach. That was a hard lesson his folks had to teach, and a much harder lesson for Jamie to learn before any other vehicle he could earn. And Jamie, no girls he ever knew would ride on a bicycle built for two. When Jamie was able to drive once more, he got a Chevy Silverado with a very high door. No kidding, that truck chassis is really so high, he needs a pilot license so that truck he can fly. Jamie, with that truck, you've had lots of fun, so sell it. Your boyhood days are done. But Jamie grew wiser. He had learned a lot. To be a man of God, he now eagerly sought. Then last year, in March 2010, Jamie asked for baptism, and then he endeavored to walk in that new life. He was finished with girls. He didn't need a wife. And our God, who doesn't sleep or slumber, had Susan Bramble with a Newport Beach number. We encouraged Jamie to give the girl a call. So along comes Tracy, and he thought, what a doll. When Tracy was little, she never would smile. Her mommy tried for such a long while. The corners of Tracy's mouth up she would pull. It never worked. Tracy just remained cool. But she's improved. She's smiling tonight. She knows in her heart she's doing something right. Because in life, be it short or of length, the joy of the Lord is always our strength. When Tracy was younger, she made mistakes too. Once away to Australia, she eagerly flew. She too learned a lesson. It's not good to roam. She really was glad when she came back home. And you know, I think really that Tracy's quite sane, but she told all her friends that she just loved the rain. So to live in Seattle, away Tracy went, I'm not sure how long there she spent. She did get the rain all day and all night. Her love then for rain went way out of sight. So back to California and the lovely warm climate, no longer Tracy, the rainforest primate. Tracy looks little, but she's really tough. Yeah, that's not in the poem, I guess. Tracy looks little, but she's really tough. She's very mechanical and likes to fix stuff. She carries with her a humongous toolbox at repairing machinery. She really rocks. So, Jamie, any repairs needed in your married life, save money on tradesmen, just call your wife. Now, about dogs, I have something to say. Which dog will they keep or give away? If I was Tracy, I would be real choosy and say, Jamie, you can keep the choosy. But my favorite dog, Millie, she's not. And I know you like her quite a lot. Though I don't know Tracy, how sure will I be that she won't say, Jamie, it's Millie or me? Tracy has a little dog, its name is Hope, and it can't, I'm sure, with Millie cope. For Tuesday the pit bull, I know in my mind that to Tracy's dog he'd be gentle and kind. So that's the dilemma. Which dog has to go? They might keep them all, you never know. So now you're married, you're husband and wife. We all make mistakes as we travel through life. You're sure to have problems, all of us do. Take them to God and he'll see you through. You won't always have sunshine, a desert could make. The storm clouds come, so God's hand you'll take, and blessing as you trust him to lead you each day. Let him be the guide on life's checkered way. Truer words have ne'er been spoken. A threefold cord is not easily broken. Tied together with God, that strong third cord gets stronger as you read and obey his word. Jamie and Tracy, you're now one in the Lord. Together, take time to read his word. Always give God first place in your life, and you're sure to be happy as husband and wife. Tracy and Jamie, the Lord bless you with gladness that knows no decay, with the riches that cannot pass away, with the brightness that makes an endless day. Thus may he bless you and keep you with the all-covering shadow of his wings, with the strong love that guards from evil things, with the sure power that safety glory brings. Thus may he keep you. Jamie and Tracy, the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face towards you and give you his peace. Love from Anna.
Together.
Hold on together.
Hold this one together. That one.
Together.
And people who think monetary value or different things, we might not, but in eyes of God, we're going to. And we're going to serve Him and help people, and just, I'm looking forward to it. So I'd like to cheers to everyone that has helped us, that helped and made this day possible. Also to my beautiful bride, who will be choosing for him. Get out here, great work. Where's Big Drew?
All right, yeah, single guys, we've waited for you. The time has come. Here we go, Jamie. Will you guys help me count on three? Why don't you put the tall guy on the outside? There you go, right there. On three, help me out now. One, two.
Come away with me in the night. come away with me. Now we arrive. You saw. Come away with me. Come away where they can't tempt us with their lies. And I wanna walk with you on a cloudy day. Fields where the yellow grass grows knee high. So won't you try? Come away with me and we'll kiss on a mountain top. Come away with me and I'll never stop loving.
Stay with it and keep God in the middle of your life.
Say a little something,
something. Oh, yeah. All right. Jamie, Tracy, salute to the both of you. Great day. Jamie, we go way back, man. So many good memories. Playing hockey in your garage, and trying not to hit your dad's Jaguar, to shoot the goops out on the street, chasing people down. That's just kind of. See, that part headed out. It didn't come out right. You know what I'm talking about. Firecrackers coming inside garages. But didn't, you know what I'm talking about, Jamie. So, just great times, man. Go way back, cards, collections, high school, all sorts of good times. So, just going for the both of you. I hope you enjoy every minute of Visalia. And I also hope you can find a way to get back down south real quick, man, because we miss you. Even though I get to see you a few times a year, because I got family up there as well. But anyway, man, stoked for the both of you. Have a great day. So great to see you too, man. Cheers, man.
Great.
Thank you, sir.
Hi, Jamie, Tracy. Just wanted to say congratulations. I'm really excited for the both of you. And Tracy, I'm really excited. I've been looking forward to having a sister my whole life. So now I finally have one. So congrats and love you guys.
How do I know Jamie? I'm his dad. And he's a great guy. And I've been praying for a long time that he was going to find the right gal. And obviously he has. Incredible service, and it was because it was so sincere. And Jamie and Tracy, I wish you absolutely the best. Love you. Bye.
All right, Jamie. I'm so happy for you, man. I'm so glad I was able to be here. Beautiful ceremony, beautiful bride. Just really a pleasure for me to be here. I gotta kick it around a little bit, you know. Viola, junior year, I met you, you know, when we first met. It was more like, for me, it was like a competitive thing because we were always playing dominoes, we were always competing in some kind of game, pool. I was like, who does this guy think he is? You know, he's better than me at pool, you know. He competes with me at dominoes. Obviously, I'm way better at sports. But, you know, your knowledge of hip-hop, your knowledge of sports, I was like, you know, I can connect with this guy. We had so many good times. But I've always respected, you know, your originality. I've appreciated your loyalty as a friend. And, you know, your work ethic. And here you are. So proud of you. So I just wish you all the best. Tracy, your new life together, I know it's going to be awesome. Congratulations. Love you, brother.
Just wait, are you ready?
Go ahead.
Tracy and Jamie, this is really fun just to say congratulations. It's been so much fun to be a part of this. The most and thank God I'm here. And we love you, Tracy. We love both of you now. But we love you, your family. I am speechless.
Amen. Tracy.
are you still speaking to me? Because I didn't want to tell everything. We all make mistakes, but I love you dearly, and I pray for you each day, and that you'll have a happy married life, and stay as long married as Papa and I did, 63 years. So, goodbye for now, and I'm glad I came to your wedding. My love to you. Is that it?
That's it, thank you.
Okay. You're
still recording it, yeah.
Oh, we got some more people.
Okay. You want my profile? My number.
You're not getting arrested.
Hi, Jamie.
So happy for both of you. Excited. We have a wonderful life. Great honeymoon.
I think we're back, so we're going to this work anyway.
thanks so much for including me in your special day. I'm so happy for you, so excited for your life, and just so blessed to have been a part of it over the last, I don't know how many years, 20-something years or whatever. Best wishes. I hope you guys have a wonderful, wonderful time in Mexico. I can't wait to come visit you. I will visit. I will take you on the first Fridays together, but we'll have to make it up with some road trips and stuff. Hit Vegas again, I think. I love you and so happy for you. And have a wonderful, wonderful honeymoon.
And you know how much I love you. I'm kind of fond of you. So I'm not very good. But all I want to say to you and Tracy is that I love you and I'm proud of you. And I want to honor you and say that I bless you. And I know that in your life together you're going to prove great things. And you know what? I've always said God restores the wasted years. It's not a big thing. It's not anything. It's just moving forward and trusting Him. And when you obey, He follows. So all the best to you both. I'm so delighted to be here.
Hi, Jamie.
What's up, Jamie? Just want to say congratulations!
No bad dogs.
No bad dogs.
No bad dogs.
No bad dogs.
None.
They're very bad. Bad, bad, bad.
He'll know what this means. You know.
Congratulations. Have fun in Mexico.
Yeah. Have fun in Mexico.
Remember the good old days when we dropped bombs, scored 10 points a game in hockey at the Irvine Hockey Club. Backhand top shelf. Mackenzie, little boy.
Remember when I had my college match and you were on the cage, dude? Chain link fence going nuts on the Notre Dame players?
Yeah, no one likes Notre Dame.
We don't like Notre Dame. Bad people.
Yeah,
actually, they're very nice. But
we're going to keep this PG and just say.
Very PG.
Because good times,
we know.
Glad to come out from Chicago, see the buddies here. And we're really happy
SCCG.
For you.
SCCG.
Yeah, there is SCCG. Glenn Dross, Babel. Yeah, giving us. Giving us.
Us!
There we go. There we go. I'm going to keep going.
Do
you edit this?
Keep going.
Tracy, we love you. We wish you God's blessings, and we're so happy to be here.
Congratulations and best wishes to you both. May God be with you and protect you and guide you and keep you safe. Enjoy. Have a great life together. Hope it's as good as Marilyn and life. My name's Tim. And not much profound to say than no mad dogging.
He was
no
just,
bad dogging.
He was just walking by.
Not mad dog. I don't know what that means, but you do. And I'm happy that that's going to be good. Congratulations, guys. This is so exciting for you. No French kissing either. Okay? Out.
Great.
Over and out.
Thank you very much. We'll keep that.
Yeah, still in there?